then we are in the 5G network. In fact, the changes in our core network are quite significant. Then we have a concept called service-oriented core network architecture. That is, the design of our entire core network is business-oriented. Why do we design such a core network structure? Because we need to support the requirements of future differentiated vertical industries, the business of differentiated vertical industries. So we will design such a new core network architecture. So it is a business-oriented core network architecture. Let's take a look at some new features of this core network. First, we see this 5G core network. We said it is called a service-oriented core network. We call it SOC for short. In fact, it is our service-oriented core, a shorthand for a service-oriented core network. It will support all these access methods. For this core network, it doesn't particularly care about how you access it. In fact, when we looked at our SA architecture earlier, we accessed it wirelessly. You may access it wirelessly through 5G or you may access it wirelessly through 4G. In fact, these are all access methods. Of course, there may also be fixed network cables or fiber optic access methods. In fact, for this service-oriented core network architecture, it doesn't particularly care about how you access it, whether you access it through 2G, 3G, 4G, 5G, or Wi-Fi, or NB-IoT, or fixed networks. It doesn't particularly care. You just connect what end users to this core network, and then the core network does business control, but how to access it. In fact, for the core network, it doesn't particularly care. This is the new SOC architecture of its core network. In fact, it can support all access methods. In fact, in the future, our fixed network can be integrated with the mobile network. Some businesses of some fixed networks can also be accessed to the future-oriented 5G core network. Another point is that it needs to support all application scenarios, or to say, support all businesses. For example, we need to support this ordinary voice call business, need to support this video business, even support this autonomous driving, unmanned driving business, including our industrial manufacturing, smart city telemedicine. Many are what we originally did not have for individual users. For example, we used to only have voice and video services for individual users. But in the future, facing vertical industries, we will have this business demand for autonomous driving, industrial manufacturing requirements, the business needs of smart cities. And this 5G core network needs to support all businesses. And we know that these different business applications, its requirements for this network are different. So the 5G core network also needs to be flexible enough to be able to adapt to these differentiated business requirements. So this is also a problem that the 5G core network needs to solve. So what do we call it? It is a core network oriented to business. This core network needs to be able to adapt to different business needs. How does it adapt to these different business needs? There will be several key technologies inside COPS is our implementation of the separation of control plane and user plane. Another one is our SBA. This is a new architecture based on business or oriented to business. Another point is that it needs to support slicing capabilities because you can only realize a physical network through slicing, support differentiated business requirements. So the ability to slice is also very important in the 5G network. Of course, another point is that we are cloud native or called native cloud because in the traditional 2G, 3G and 4G fields, telecom equipment is all dedicated equipment. They are all quite expensive. And based on this x86 architecture cloud data center. In fact, we all use some of these rack servers or blade servers. The price of this ordinary server will be a bit cheaper. Then we can form a cloud data center by putting many of these rack servers or blade servers, then to provide our computing power, storage capabilities, and these network capabilities. In this way, the expansion and contraction of the network will be more flexible. And the overall hardware investment, the capital investment in hardware will also be reduced a bit. This is the value brought by our native cloud. First of all, it no longer uses our traditional dedicated hardware. In this way, the price of hardware will be reduced and our way based on this cloud, the expansion and contraction of the network will be more flexible. This is our 5G core network oriented to business. This 5G core network we will enable all vertical industry businesses through such key technologies. These are the features of our 5G core network. We have several key technologies: separation of control plane and user plane, SBA, business oriented architecture, and slicing, and this native cloud. This is our core network architecture, or some key technologies that enable. We mentioned a concept called SBA in the network architecture called service-based architecture. Of course, service-based architecture, this was proposed by China Mobile and written into the 3GPP 5G standard service-based architecture. We mean the whole core. The design of the entire network architecture is service-oriented, is based on services. Then we can compare the traditional 4G core network and the new 5G core network. What is the difference between them, right? First, we look at the green part on the left. These are some key elements of our 4G core network. We have MME, right? This is our control plane. That is our mobility management entity. Then we have two gateways, right? Called service gateway and PDN gateway. It is mainly to deal with, we do the forwarding of our user plane data. Of course, it also has certain control plane functions. Next, we have our HSS. It is our user's home server, right? Our user's account information. You bought a SIM card. The account information of the SIM card will all be written in the HSS. We also have something called PCRF. It does some QoS. It does some policy and billing control. In the 4G era, these are all network elements. For example, you have to buy some of these dedicated hardware devices. Deploy these network elements on hardware devices. Of course, we will later. We also have some virtualization solutions. Our 4G core network now, we know we call it EPC. Of course, we also have some VEPC solutions now. That is the virtualized EPC solution. We can also deploy some 4G network elements deployed in this server. It can also be in a standard x86 server. We have the traditional EPC and the virtualized VEPC. Actually, this is also a process of our evolution towards 5G, or it is also a technical trend. Then in the 5G era, we no longer have these dedicated network elements. They are all some Fs, right? This F is all functions. For example, we can understand it as they are all these microservices. Then our traditional 4G core network, it has so many functions. When it comes to 5G, we may still need most of these functions, but I will split these network elements, split some 4G network elements into many different functions. For example, our MME. In this, it mainly does mobility management and control. When it comes to 5G, we will split it into AMF and SMF. This AMF is for some control plane processing. Then it is to do our access and mobility management functions. Then SMF is to do session management functions. Actually, these two functions were integrated in such a network element in the MME. Then when it comes to 5G, it turns into a function. This may be a bit special. In the 4G era, these are all network elements. We call it network element. But when it comes to the 5G era, we will see they have all turned into functions. We can deploy them in the form of microservices or in the form of virtual machines. So this is an upgrade from hardware to software, or a change. Of course, we also have some other network elements in the 4G era. We have many functions in these network elements. When it comes to the 5G era, they all turn into this F. For example, the SGW in the 4G era, the call serving gateway, we will turn it into SMF and UPF. It's the user plane in the core network. But you can call it UPF. That is our user plane function to do user plane data forwarding and processing. Of course, PGW will also have such user plane functions. It separates its control plane and user plane separated. All user plane functions are placed in UPF or VR inside. All kinds of control plane functions are extracted, placed in our core network control plane. Of course, we will also have some AUSF to do our authentication and our these SMSF, NRF, PCF, etc. We took the original 4G in the 4G core network. We have a lot of business control functions deployed in different network elements. When it comes to the 5G era, we extract these functions, put the control plane on the control plane. All user planes are concentrated together and we no longer need some dedicated hardware network elements. These are all functions. We can use virtual machines or in the form of microservices deployed in the cloud data center deployed in our x86 architecture server. So this is a very important change it brings. This is our service-based architecture. Of course, in the future, we will control the core network. We can also stack some on-demand in these functions third-party applications. For example, some ISP internet companies, they will develop some new applications. We can integrate these applications. Then in this way, our network will become more and more open. Then IT and CT are gradually merging. We will integrate some good ideas of IT, good applications integrated into our network. Finally, we will see the access part, right? In the 4G era, we access the 4G core network through an LTE wireless access network, access to the 4G core network. But when we were in 4G, we call it E-Node B, right? When it comes to 5G, we still have this network element, right? This is our access through 5G and our technology, right? Of course, this network element is what we just mentioned, right? It's called G-Node B. Of course, the future 4G network, it is also the future 4G site. It can also be connected to the 5G core network. Of course, the 4G site needs to be upgraded. We call it EELT after the upgrade. It is called EELT. It can access the stock 4G site. After upgrading to EELT, it can access the 5G core network, 5G core network, control plane, 5G core network, user plane. Of course, they also need to go through the interface, right? Access to our core network, control plane, N2 user plane, N3, right? Actually, it's our NGU, NGC, NGU, good. This is our 5G, a service-based network. Architecture first. We look at the network elements in the 4G era, our large-scale network, right? The network elements are tightly coupled. Then if you want to implement some new services, new functions, you need to deploy a new network element. Then such a cycle will be very long, at least 6 months or more, right? For example, to purchase new equipment from the manufacturer, new equipment arrives, install, adjust, and launch the business. The whole cycle will be long, but in the future, we will base on this native cloud architecture. We have reduced our interfaces actually in the 4G era. We have many interfaces here, right? Apart from what we see here, S1 MME, S1U, control plane and user plane interfaces. We have many other interfaces here, like the S5 interface here. We also have our S6A interface and so on. GXRX interface, S10, SC11 interface and many more. But in the 5G era, we have reduced the number of interfaces in the core network control plane. We have many functions, many features, but these features, they are all based on standard interfaces for invocation, similar to our IT concept. We don't have such personalized open interfaces, no more. They are all invoked through internal services, so the whole network will be simpler. So in the 5G era, our entire network architecture based on the 5G network architecture, we have reduced our interfaces. The whole network is extremely simple because all these functions of ours are deployed in the form of virtual machines or microservices deployed. You deploy it in a virtual machine, you deploy it in a container. This is the whole core network part. Then the whole network will become simpler. We don't have as many different network elements as before deployed in different hardware boxes. In the future, we will all be deployed in cloud data centers. Similarly, we have decoupled functions in the 4G era. MME has AMF function and SMF function and some other functions. To SGW, PGW, it has the control planes SMF function and our user planes data transformation function. But in the 5G era, all functions are decoupled. Control plane belongs to the control plane, user plane belongs to the user plane, and our entire network is what OpenIt should be able to effectively integrate third-party applications. We open the API interface, then if there are good third-party applications, we directly inherit. Finally, all these functions and services of ours are independent of each other. If you need it, then go to call the service. Calling the service is enough. This is the characteristic of our new 5G network architecture. So let's summarize. Isn't it that the control plane, the user plane is separated, CUPS control, user plane, separation. The control plane and the user plane are separated. What else is there? What are we? Our core networks, control plane and user plane can all be deployed on cloud data centers. It is a native cloud. Another thing, we can support slicing because we have split the functions of the core network elements into many functions at this time for different business demands. I can choose to call arrange different functions. For example, I now have a business application one. I may only need four functions. I only choose four functions, form a network slice. Another business application two, I may need eight functions. I arrange eight functions into a slice. So it will become more flexible to enable our vertical industries through this slicing technology. This is our 5G core network architecture. Through this slicing technology, this is the architecture of our 5G core network.